ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's welcome to perform for us, to minister for us this evening, Mr. Ryzen with one and a half. So, sorry. Good.
Trinidad and Tobago, have a safe and peaceful Christmas. Don't go out there and get yourself into any trouble, you know. All right. Everybody eating, having a time. This love in the atmosphere make the sweetest line. But all that smile will tilt a frong. If when I come for second rounds, it have no food in the oven. If I can't smell ham. If I can't smell turkey. To smell a smoke in the kitchen. That sweet Christmas smell, so I could tell everything you cook is so. Hey, pull it, wheel. That was the half. Run to you. Father, create in me a clean heart and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Within me. Everybody, clean out your heart. Wash it with the blood until it's shiny, shiny and new. Hard mind, well, I clean in that. I love see, I clean in that too. Rachel, well, I clean in that. This Christmas is everybody. Clean out your heart for Christmas. Wash it with the blood until it's shiny, shiny and new. Well, I clean in that. Well, I clean in that too. Well, I clean in that. This Christmas, I clean in the curtains, the cushions and the rug. Scrub and wash away that envy. Well, I clean in that jealousy. I clean in that too. Hatred. Well, I clean in that. This Christmas I clean anyway. And everywhere I turn, I see people cleaning up and painting up their home. But what about the inside, where the spirit resides? It could never be right if we keep neglecting the Most High. I know that Jesus loves me. Left the glory of the heavens for the earth. Where he lived for me, and he bled for me, and he died for me. So this Christmas, everybody, clean out your heart for Christmas. Wash it with the blood until it's shiny, shiny and new. Well, I clean in that. Well, I clean in that too. Well, I clean in that. This Christmas is everybody, clean out your heart for Christmas. Wash it with the blood till it's shiny, shiny and new. Envy, well, I clean in that. Jealousy, well, I clean in that. Hatred, well, I clean in that. This Christmas, I not saying, don't pretty up your home. But how the outside looks should never be your main concern. Focus on the inside, where the spirit resides. It could never be right if we keep neglecting the Most High. I know that Jesus loves me. Left the glory of the heavens for the earth. Where he lived for me. Well, I clean in that too. Jealousy, well, I clean in that. This Christmas is everybody. Clean out your heart for Christmas. Wash it with the blood until it's shiny, shiny and new. Well, I clean in that. Well, I clean in that too. Well, I clean in that. This Christmas I clean in. Everything I clean must stay clean. Everything I clean must stay clean. Clean must stay clean. Let me explain. If they bring their badness here, I go in so,
go in so.
If they bring their folly here, I go in so,
go in so.
If they bring their hatred here, I go in so,
go in so.
If they bring their folly over here, I go in so. Father, create in me a clean heart, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Wash it with the blood until it's shiny, shiny and new. And we will are clean in that. Jealousy, well, I clean in that too. Hatred, well, I clean in that. This Christmas is everybody. Clean out your heart for Christmas. Wash it with the blood until it's shiny, shiny and new. On my will I clean in that. Jealousy, well, I clean in that too. Hatred, well, I clean in that. This Christmas I clean.
pleasant good evening and welcome once again to Cloud 9 on ACT and The Voice. Real vibes, as they say. These last few days right here in the Southland, San Fernando, on top of the hill. Yes, ACT and students, it has been a wonderful week thus far. It will bring the rhythm Christmas special. It has been some powerful ministry, lots of laughs, lots of fun, but most important, lots of love as we share with TNT this Christmas season. Tonight, it will be no different. Just get ready for 8 p.m. Make sure you know where to be right here at ACT and The Voice. Now, that beginning with that song today was, well, as you say, intentional, because I want to jump straight into our Wise Up segment today. And as you mentioned, well, yesterday we did the same thing, and we're going to show you highlights from the last few nights of the Bring the Rhythm special. So you know which was the highlight for me last night, the parang. Hey, try a thing. Try being the operative word. But it wasn't too bad. At least I hope so. Right? But an article that got my attention, and I sat down, I read it thoroughly, analyzed it. My wife and I spoke about it, prayed about it, and I'm going to give my responses. Let's go to our Wise Up segment at this time. And it's one of the many stories that you've been seeing this Christmas season. I want to put this into context and give some advice to anyone who may be in a situation prior to what happened to this family. Let's go. All right. So this story, I'm going to read just a portion of it for you. Let's get the picture up if we can. It's a story in the Guardian newspaper. Right? All right. There it is. So leave it up for a while. It's called Christmas in a Cowshed. I'm going to read clearly, but with a little pace, so bear with me. Usually around this time, Seema Ramsrup and her 8 children would be busy decorating their Kuva home in preparation for Christmas. Shopping would have already been done and cooking would have started. But with Ramsarup's common law husband, Krishna Rampasad's death earlier this year, fending off snakes and mosquitoes is how the family will celebrate the birth of Christ. From living with pipe-borne water, electricity, and a roof over their heads, Ramsarup, her children ages 3 to 21, twin grandsons, and age 2 and daughter-in-law 23, now live in a home that resembles a cowshed. In February, the sole breadwinner died of a heart attack, and days later, Rampasad's relative told them they had to move out. She stood her ground, saying the house was left by her husband for their children. The family was eventually evicted in June, and the house was demolished. The furniture and appliances were dumped outside Ramsrup's maternal home in Princeton. Rain destroyed their belongings as they had nowhere to store them. Without anywhere to live, she moved into a shack located nearby. Hampers of food and clothes were given to the family, but little was done to change their lives. The children's mother said she approached the Housing Development Corporation and was included in a lengthy list of social cases who are awaiting accommodation. Quote, "It's been 2 months now. We are living in the bush here, and it is the worst we've experienced. This is like where animals would live. It's just mud all around." All right. It was a task for the news team to reach the shack in Glen Roy, Princeton, as the walkway of broken bricks was sinking in slippery and thick mud. Rusted, jagged galvanized sheets thrown together made up the outdoor toilet and bath area. A worn piece of vinyl covered the flooring of the shack. A broken bed and 2 pieces of sponge are what they sleep on. 2 stoves, a few dishes, and donated clothing are all they possess. Bundled together in the shack of the family have no idea what Christmas they will bring. Quote, "They went to a Christmas party over the weekend and that will be it for them. We're trying to see if we can get help from Habitat for Humanity to build something." Right, I'm going to fast track here. It's almost done. "I sent an application and I was told that there was a process, so I'd have to wait. It's been 2 or 3 months and there has been nothing. I went to HSC twice and they told me I would have to wait and they would get back to me. Life has been a struggle," Ramsrup said. Growing up in poverty at 15, she began a relationship with Rampasad, who was then 33. At 17, she was pregnant and moved into his home. She had 10 children and suffered a life of abuse at his hands until he died. Right.
All right. There are a myriad, a pyramid rather, of issues that we need to take a look at here. Poverty, neglect, and the list goes on and on, right? You also have education as an aspect of it, the whole concept of family planning, and the list goes on and on. Now, I want us to pay attention to the last part of the story, right? She was 15, he was 33. So this relationship that she engaged in with this older man was a means of escape. Unfortunately, it's like escaping one prison and going into a bigger prison. It's just in this prison you have more room to run, but only for a short while. Because, again, you're feeling trapped because you feel you have no other choice. Right? Now, I've been looking at some of the comments on social media. Some of them very insensitive, obviously. And I want people to understand there is something called bondage of poverty and bondage of slavery in the mind. And what we're seeing here is a classic case of generational curses that she of herself, because of the prison that she has been living in since 15, does not know how to break for herself nor her children, right? And it will continue if no one helps her break that mindset. It is not about the house. It's not about, you know, getting a nice house or a nice car, because you can have all of that and still be in prison. You can have all of that and still be in prison. And I want people who have been very insensitive to this to understand this. This is more than just her. And I heard somebody made the point as well that this is probably one of the few, this is probably the first time in terms of media publicly that she has expressed the abuse that she would have suffered at his hands, right? So if there's no one to help her come out of that mindset of poverty, a mindset of abuse, then therefore she would think that this is okay. It goes back to that same analogy I made about Egypt. And when, you know, the Israelites were taken out of Egypt and they went into the wilderness where God could have taken them and molded them and groomed them in the harsh realities of life, as they say, make your back broad. So when the pressures of life come, then therefore you are able to withstand the storms, as they say. But no. They wanted to go back to Egypt. They made a comment to Moses like, listen, when we were in Egypt, we were fed, we were given food. And they were like, Moses was like, you fools. You're being fed to be fattened for the kill. You're just being used, pawns, slaves, still in prison. And that is where many of us are. We get comfortable in the prison because again, in some cases, there's no one to take us out. There's no one to lead us out. In the Israelites' case, God sent Moses to lead them out. How many of us here are willing to be like Moses and be obedient to the call to lead some people out of this mindset? Again, it's not about the house, because you can get the house and get the car and get the clothes and you're still in prison. But Mali said it as well. Right? You could still be in prison. So I want us to be, you know, read the whole story in its context and not be too quick to pass judgment. That's one. Right? Secondly, and this is a side note, because I've seen other cases like this as well, whereby, same thing, husband passed away, but in these cases, the husband would have, you know, been there with the family. Not cases of abuse, but I want to draw this attention, to these families, and I want to speak to men in particular. I have seen cases in the media as well. I have interviewed families along those same lines where the husband is alive and, you know, living in situations whereby it's by an in-law, by this one, by that one, and, you know, things are tough. But I want to say this to these men who have your families. You have to think of the future, and it is imperative upon you to ensure that your family is provided for outside of just a meal in the event of your passing before any one of them, in terms of your wife or your, as the case may be, right? You, as the head of the house, will have to put things in place. And what I want to advise men, once you can afford it, focus less on how much food you could get, but focus more on providing a stable home for your family. Ensure your home, ensure your property once you can. Get a proper. Strategize. People always say, oh, to strategize. Because I have seen it and I've learned from these experiences. 15, 20 years pass and you say, I couldn't do anything. There were no means for me to acquire this or to do this. Don't say never, because we try to do it on our own strength. And that is why for many years, many men grow old and die and have not been able to secure and put things in place for their family. So when something like this happens now, as just in a general scenario, families are out on the street, nowhere to go, because nothing was put in place. And I remember Rex Battle, who said this very openly when we had the flood relief. He said, many people have they have a taboo mindset when it comes to insurance. So they will build these very, large houses at times on pieces of land that they would have acquired from generation to generation. That's all well and good, but they do not insure the property. So if the property burns down, you have nothing to get. It's the same thing. You have a property, right? And what happens if something happens to you? House burned down, because things happen, life happens. So my thing is, it's about being prepared. So I'm saying for 2018, to all families there, it is time to start strategizing. Look at different ways and techniques of, number one, securing your family first, secure them, and everything else will fall into place. We put the cart before the horse too many times. That's just two quick scenarios I'm bringing to your attention, and I hope people will be a more sensitive to the first issue. Because again, read the whole story in its context, and then you will understand what's happening here. Let's take a break. When we come back, we go to our Let's Chat segment, and it's Parang on Cloud.Nine.
It's beginning to look a lot like
that's right, people. It's that time of year again, and we here at ACTN The Voice have got you covered. All your favorite Christmas music and movies every day.
Wait, did you say every day?
Jingle bell.
Yes, every day. Tune into ACTN The Voice as we spread the good news of the true meaning of Christmas. No one does Christmas like us. ACTN, The Voice of Christmas.
We are taking you to higher heights in 2018. Yes, that's right. Cloud.Nine is going live at 5. The show that makes you smile will have you smiling even more as we're coming to you from 5 p.m. Mondays to Fridays right here on ACTN The Voice. Get ready for a liftoff.
We're bringing Christmas to you with all your favorite artists. Don't miss Bring the Rhythm Christmas, Monday 18th December to Friday 22nd December, 8 p.m. nightly, live on ACTN, The Voice of Christmas.
Welcome back to Cloud.Nine on ACTN. The Voice. I'm going to switch our focus once again to the Bring the Rhythm Christmas special. Continues tonight at 8 p.m. So let's chat, or better yet, let's parang.
Mm-hmm.
right, so this particular group, all the way from Aruka, man, they truly blessed us last evening. I am a lover of music, and I could not speak Spanish to save my life, but I love it. And I'm really glad that they came all the way from, you know, the East to bless us with their music. And as they truly say, anointing makes the difference, because you hear all kind of different parambans singing all kind of stuff, you know, about Ram and this and that and that. They sang and they exalted the Savior in their music, and you heard. I mean, the anointing was there, and that is truly what makes a difference. So, without further ado, let's go now. Let's return to last evening with Parang on Bring the Rhythm.
I am Sheldon Yearwood, and this is everybody else. Last two nights, this was just one or two. Now I have a whole Parang band. Now, right now, you know, before we go any further, I want to say thanks again to the One Movement Youth Band. Every night, truly setting the atmosphere for the welcoming of the Holy Spirit in this place to truly minister to you, our loyal viewers. But tonight, I'm happy like a kid in a candy store. Because I love Parang, but I cannot speak Spanish to save my life. My 8-year-old daughter could do better than me. This is Luces del Mundo. I had to roll the D. Even if her song little foolish is all right.
Excellent.
That's okay. Thank you for coming. Where are you all from, first of all?
Well, actually, we're coming from Aruka, from Faith Assembly International. We are under our pastor, Jason Bishu, all right? And we are part of the bilingual service. We have a Spanish service every Sunday at 6 o'clock. And the service is simultaneous, English and Spanish. Mm-hmm. And that's how this band was actually created 5 years ago. And we have people coming all the way, well, from Paramin. We have people coming, well, different parts of Trinidad. And we love Spanish, and we worship in Spanish and English, of course. And then, well, 5 years ago, we said, let's create a band. And actually, all the songs we have, all of them are originals. Okay, we have some writers like Philip, then we have Harold, and myself. So that's how we are.
Luces del Mundo, it means the light of the world.
Light of the world, yes.
Right, was this a name that you all prayerfully decided upon? How did this all come
Yes,
about?
Actually, we were praying for the name and requesting God to give us a proper name. And then our senior pastor, well, our pastor, Pastora Roma Bishu, right? She's the one who say, guys, this is the name for the band 5 years ago, and we receive it. She's overseer, so receive it, excellent.
Well, that is what we're supposed to represent, light unto the people.
You're
so
right.
To bring them to closer to Christ. I want to ask one quick question before I let you, of course, take center stage. It is a saying that, you know, we could be alive but not living. Mm-hmm. In terms of Parang music in Trinidad and Tobago,
yes.
Would you say that in some areas, it is not living in the hearts of people, because you have soca parang, you have this. Would you say that Parang music is still alive in the hearts of people and living well?
I do believe so. Actually, we experienced in these past 2 months, we have been playing different radio stations, actually live in different places. And still, every time December, Trinidadians love to speak or try to speak Spanish, and you're one of them. But what is important is the message that we actually try to transmit through the lyrics. It's very important. Right. Because I believe Jesus is the reason for the season. I do believe that the lyrics is the message we as a band or anybody who's singing will bring to the people, even though for those who are not believers. So that's why we create our own music and so on and lyrics, just to, first on anything, worship God, yeah. And second, bring the message of the cross, which is very important. We have so many Parang songs speaking about Rios Manzanares.
Yeah, and get caught up in the festivities.
Exactly.
And the revelry.
And we always try, for a reason, try to imitate more the world, instead bring the world to imitate us.
Amen.
All right? So that's why every single lyrics we have been written here in Spanish, English, or Patois itself, is just to exalt the name of Jesus.
Wow, you know what? Well, the anointing makes a difference.
It does.
And I'm sure that you all have made a difference in the lives of many people.
Amen.
As we really remember the reason for the season. Without further ado, let us welcome to minister unto you,
Luces
del Mundo.
Hallelujah.
My tongue.
All glory be to God. Amen. Luces del mundo. Come on, everybody. Let's do it. Luces del mundo. Aleluya. Sí, señor.
Padre, guiado por el Espíritu, vino a darnos su mensaje. Jesús, te damos
las gracias.
We give you thank you, Lord. Worship you, God. But now it's time for do some song in patois. All right? Let's do it, Philippe. Hallelujah. Father, we love you, Lord. Are we ready? One more in Spanish. Let's do it, man. Give me the guitar. Is good, amen. Well, we have our last song for tonight. The song name is Shante. This song is in all the way. So come, Philip, do a Shante. Come on.
Message for the Christmas. Jesus Christ bled and died on the cross. Accept him now as your Lord and Savior, and have a blessed, bright, and prosperous New Year. Hallelujah! Wifey, daughter, son.
Hallelujah! Thank you, Trinidad and Tobago. Thank you very much for the opportunity. God bless you.
And it's at that moment I came in and mashed up the place. Yeah. Sorry, I need to lie. I apologize. Take a break. Yeah. Take a break. Take a break.
That's right, people. It's that time of year again, and we here at ACTN The Voice have got you covered. All your favorite Christmas music and movies every day.
Wait, did you say every day?
Jingle bell.
Yes, every day. Tune into ACTN The Voice as we spread the good news of the true meaning of Christmas. No one does Christmas like us. ACTN, The Voice of Christmas.
We are taking you to higher heights in 2018. Yes, that's right. Cloud9 is going live at 5. The show that makes you smile will have you smiling even more as we're coming to you from 5 p.m. Mondays to Fridays right here on ACTN The Voice. Get ready for liftoff.
Christmas to you with all your favorite artists. Miss Bring the Rhythm Christmas, Monday 18th December to Friday 22nd December, 8 p.m. nightly, live on ACTM, The Voice of Christmas.
Welcome back to Cloud 9 on ACTN. Without further ado, let's go to our silver lining segment at this time. And staying with the Christmas season, I'm digging you a blast from the past, from my past, of course, the early days that win one of the many Christmas features I have to share with you. And it just goes to show that no matter what your talent is, it's a gift from God, and God can use it to do wonders. Don't let anybody shortchange your dream.
I and my husband's parents always knew that Sayada wanted to do art. Art was her passion. When she was a little girl, I remember she drew a little dog and the tail was wagging. And I said, yes, my daughter does have talent. And when she was about 10 years old, that's what she wanted to be as a professional artist. I said, well, you just have to do what you have to do. Go through the process of school and passing all your exams before you go to university. Sarah was ready to leave school to do art. So we knew that there was nothing we could do to change her mind that wouldn't really break her as a person. So we put things in place, and Sayada was working towards it as well, and everything was going just fine. Until well, she got her scholarship, she chose her school, she visited her school before, and she knew this is where she wanted to be. She's never disappointed us. She's lived up to her challenges and really enjoyed what she's doing, and we always thought maybe she might be a poor artist. But I have to say that she's living her dream, and her career is coming to maturity, and she's finding her niche and really enjoying what she's doing and looking forward to every other new project. And that's my Sayada.
So here we are at Rainy Days, where you can find my cards as well as some watercolor paintings I've done, and a treasure trove of other local arts and crafts by all local artists. So come and see what cool things you can find.
The store has evolved over about 15 years. I'm here 17 years. And it just evolved into all local art, because some of the artists used to complain there's no marketplace for them to show their work outside of Christmas fairs. And so one by one, it started with about two, it's about 100 different artists. Everything in here is somebody else. And I love the local art and culture, so this is like my joy. So there's no wealth involved in this. It's just, I love the space that the artists provide for me. I've never been in touch with any one of my artists. Okay. They always arrive, which is a blessing for me. And so I don't know how she came to know about the shop, because this is what I always hope for, that the local artists would find me because I'm the place where they can show their work. And so usually it's by word of mouth. Maybe another artist would say, well, go to Rhonda, you know, she will show out your work.
Rhonda has been doing such a good job at supporting and encouraging local artists by stocking all of our artwork and crafts and books and all of these things at her shop.
Her whole energy I love, and I think she has the right approach. She's very humble, and I think she'll remain that way even though she makes it big. I suppose she has the support back home, and I love to sell her local cards. It projects our local life here, which the foreigners like to buy. Because you don't have to be living abroad to buy this stuff. The locals, once you appreciate local stuff, give your friends local. I don't think people realize all of this is local. They come like, it's so good. Why can't it be good? It's local.
I encourage everyone to come down to the store and see what interesting things you can find. There's always local, always unique things here. So support your local artists and buy local.
The snowman is shaping up to be an 8, but not out of 10. The robots awake to find that they've been taped down, wondering when they'll break through these chains.
I've always been interested in art. I love drawing and painting and all of that since I was little. And since I realized that you could do that as a job, that is what I wanted as my career. So I took all the necessary steps to make sure that took place. And so now I'm pursuing my career in illustration as well as fine arts. So fine arts is more of painting and stuff you'd hang in a gallery. Painting, drawing, sculpture. Well, I don't do sculpture yet. but painting and drawing is more of a side job to the illustration, which is, for example, drawings for like storybooks or textbooks or like the Christmas cards as well. So in the future, I'm hoping to do more books, maybe book covers or album covers even. Also, I'd like to do more in advertising. So like designing or daily drawings for packaging and stuff like that. I think that would be a really interesting way to go. What I wanted to do with the cards was to show what a Trinity Christmas really looks like and to bring that sense of warmth and fun into it and to have something that you can give somebody and make them smile. That's why I named it Design for a Smile. So one of the cards that people really liked was the one of the little girl looking at the Christmas ham. I call it eyeing the Christmas ham. On the table is a bottle of punch a creme. There's a black cake nicely decorated, and there's this nice juicy ham, which I don't personally eat ham, but I know a lot of people go crazy for that around Christmas time. So the idea was a little child just can't wait to get her hands on a piece of that ham. Another one is Santa at the beach, and it's the concept behind it is everybody loves to go to Maracas Bay on Boxing Day. So after Santa has worked so hard on Christmas Eve getting presents to everybody, the place he wants to go is Maracas Bay with Mrs. Claus and of course all the little elves who brought their swimsuits and so on so they can play in the sun. I like putting in little details into the cards that make them unique. So like with the Santa on the beach, you'll see in one corner there's not a snowman but a sandman that's shaped like a little snowman and made in sand. And a little boy, he's the only one that really notices that, hey, this looks like Santa Claus. I think it's Santa Claus. So he's all shocked with his pail and scoop.
Now the girls up the street are innocent and sweet while they're all in bed. They got their makeup and dreams of wonderland sprinkled inside their heads. And soon they will change. But tonight, Hollywood Hills never seem so strange. Their mother's praying.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Remember it like yesterday. And I just want to say that's a good reminder for how privileged and how blessed and how, you know, grateful we should be to be in Trinidad and Tobago, to this wonderful Twin Island Republic. God has blessed us with so much, and sometimes you take it for granted. But we here at ACT and The Voice, we are not taking the season for granted, as every night from Monday up until tomorrow night, yes, tomorrow night is the end, bringing you, of course, and ministering to you through song. It continues tonight right here at 8 p.m. right here at ACTN The Voice. See you later. God bless you.